Today we're going to learn how to make a hologram like the one you just saw. They're called scratch holograms, and all you need is a piece of plastic and a compass. But first, let me explain what a hologram is. So let's say we want to make a hologram of this little man. First, we'll shine a red laser at him. We use a laser because we want the light to be coherent, that is, to have a constant wavelength. Some of the light that hits the little man will be reflected. The reflected light is shown here as a series of wavefronts. The light moves out perpendicular to these wavefronts. The white screen here is the detector, either a digital sensor or a piece of film. If we let the reflected light and a reference beam, here shown as a parallel beam, interfere, we'll generate a fringe pattern. This fringe pattern is known as the hologram. If we shine the reference beam back on the hologram, a reconstructed image of the little man will appear. Now, that's not how we're going to be making these scratch holograms. We won't need a laser or film. All we have to do is create a bunch of circular scratches in our piece of plastic. Light will reflect from the sun into your eye from the scratch, and the light will appear to be coming from a point above the plastic. How far above the plastic will depend on the radius of your circular scratch. Let me show you one of these scratch holograms of a cube. Okay, so in green, I've drawn one of the scratches you made on your piece of plastic. Now, light rays will come from the sun, reflect off that scratch, and hit your eye. It'll look as though a point of light is hovering above the plastic. So by making a bunch of these scratches, you can build up an image point by point that appears to be jumping out of the piece of plastic at you. Now, for me, this is interesting, not only because it lets you make neat images, but because my research here at Harvard involves using circular fringes to encode 3D information. Walk over to this microscope with me. With this microscope, we can observe tiny little beads, 1 micron in diameter. You can observe one here on the screen. It's being jostled about because water molecules are constantly bumping into it. Now, this is just a regular image, like a photograph. But if we use a laser, we can record the interference between light scattered from the bead and a reference beam. Now, you see all these circular fringes? We can use the spacing of these fringes to determine where, in all three dimensions, this particle is. Now, let me show you how to make one of these scratch holograms step by step. First, sketch out the shape you want to make on the corner of your plastic. So I'm just going to sketch out my initials. So R, J, M. Now, take your compass, and both ends should have pointy ends. So take the lead out of one end and stick in something sharp like a little nail. Now put one end of the compass on your shape, whatever you sketched, and swivel the other end on the plastic. Now you should have a faint scratch, not too deep, but visible by eye. Now remember that each arc, each scratch, will result in 1 point. So you'll have to build up a lot of these scratches. in order to build up your shape. So that's it. I hope you've learned something about the research I do here and the optical tricks we use. Have fun making holograms on your own.